One of the things that happens in a Waldorf school is that everything starts with movement.
In a Waldorf school, you have this wonderful opportunity to have learning happen with the whole body. With the hands, with the feet, with the head, with the heart, with the breathing.
Their job, under the age of 7, is to move their body. Academics begin with being able to hold a pencil. Holding that pencil and making those beautiful forms with their form drawing that eventually become letters and numbers, and then eventually become cursive. And then in 6th, 7th, 8th grade, they become calligraphy. So this hand is your first tool, but you have to be able to manipulate it. And that's what the role of movement in the early grades helps form. Ideally, in a Waldorf school, every subject you bring starts with some form of movement.
One of the approaches to multiplication is to work through rhythms. So you'll often have clapping games with the times tables.
My movement class will also mirror certain elements of other classes. So I will have songs, I will have verse, there will be speech elements. So this is a really great opportunity for them to learn language.
The pentathlon is the culminating event for the 5th graders in the Waldorf School. This activity is grounded in their the whole experience that they've had in main lesson throughout the year. And the children practice, especially the more difficult ones like the javelin and the discus that are more unusual for them, throughout the year.
How you're able to move through life, the forming of that starts in these early ages.
I do a racquetball exercise, which is really Balavisics, and it's team building and it's group building.
Balavisics stands for balance, auditory, visual, and exercise. It's a beautifully harmonizing activity with balls that bounce, and we've gotten quite proficient at it.
We will do things in rhythm or meter there. I've also incorporated math into that. It's also working with listening and really being able to tune in, because actually your ears know the rhythm more than your hands do. It's challenging. It's actually very challenging, and they love it, and it's helped a lot of students with their focus. Like, you'll hear the chatter starts, and when we get going, it's really quiet. And it has to be, or you throw the beat off.
I would like to say another thing about movement in the upper grades, because more and more schools think, oh, we don't have enough time. And yet, I've seen schools that in 7th and 8th grade, they don't have any movement in the morning, and they go right to the book work. Whereas here, we have a tradition of everyone going on a walk, if not every morning, you know, a good portion, 3 out of 5 days of the week. And there's an element of social connection that children need when they get into 7th and 8th grade, and you'll see it. We'll get more and more homeschoolers that come to us in 6th, 7th, and 8th grade because those children are itching for that social connection. So if you start your day with the first 5-10 minutes of them to connect, walk, move, get their blood flowing, get their mouths talking, because they want to do that too, get it all out, and then you can be part of the intellectual aspect of the class. I want them to live in joy, in their bodies, in movement. And that's what's helping them then gain the skills, fine motor skills, gross motor skills, medium motor skills, coordination, have the tools that they can now begin to learn academics.